Hello students, today we will be discussing about series resistor. So you can imagine one cell connected to three bulbs. You can see three bulbs. These bulbs can be represented like this also, like three resistors also. Resistor 1 representing the bulb 1, resistor 2 representing the bulb 2, resistor 3 representing the bulb 3. So this is connected to a cell. A cell is mentioned over here. This cell can be represented in the circuit diagram as shown over here. Okay. So these resistors are connected in series. What is the meaning of series is that the head of the series is connected to the tail end. This is the tail end. This is the head end. This is the resistor. So this is the tail end. Again, the head end will come of the second resistor. It is connected to the tail end. Again, the head of the third resistor will come. It is connected to the tail end. And the last tail end is connected to the negative terminal. And the first head is connected to the positive terminal. So same current flows through all the resistors. This is a very important concept what you need to remember. In series resistance, what happens is that I is the current. We can denote it by capital I. Okay. Here I have denoted as small I. So capital I and small I is the current which passes through the resistor. In the series resistors, you should always remember that the current is the same across R1, across R2, across R3. Okay. The current remains the same. Now calculating the potential difference. What is potential difference? Potential difference is V. So V have to calculate. So before that, we can represent this series resistance like this also. Okay, where this is the positive terminal, the head end is connected to the positive terminal. Now the tail end is connected to the head of the second R2, and the tail of the R2 connects to the negative terminal. So in this way also this can be represented. Here three resistances are there, here two resistances we have mentioned. Okay, so this same diagram can be drawn like this also. This is also series. Okay, now we are calculating the potential difference. So calculating of potential difference is equal to V is equal to V1 plus V2. This is across the voltage across R1 is equal to V1. Okay, let's consider the potential difference of across this. It is called V1. Okay, potential difference. And now potential difference across R2 is equal to V2. Okay, so V is equal to V1 plus V2. The total voltage would be across R1 and across R2. Across R1 is called V1. Across R2 it is called V2 voltage. Now by Ohm's law we are already aware that by Ohm's law V is equal to IR. So we can substitute this over here in this equation. V is equal to IR we will be putting over here instead of V. And for V1 we will put IR1. And for V2 we will put I2 R2. Okay, so IR1 is equal to I is common R1 plus R2. So since both the sides I is common, we can cancel out this capital I. And now the remaining equation would be R is equal to R1 plus R2. This is an important relationship where R is the total resistance is equal to the sum of resistances. So this happens only in series resistance. So R is equal to R1 plus R2 plus Rn. So that is the concept of series resistance. Now we'll come to the parallel connection. You need to understand what is parallel connection first. So parallel connections, it is mentioned over here, is resistors. So you can see resistors connected over here. Resistors. Both the head ends are joined together and both the tail ends are joined together. So this is called parallel resistor. So these two tail ends are joined to the negative terminal and the resistances R1, R2's head end is connected to the positive. Okay, so the resistances R2 and R1, both heads are connected and both tails are connected. Okay, the current from the battery from the positive terminal, which is the positive terminal, this is the positive terminal. Okay, this is the voltage or the cell, and the current flows. I is flowing and it reaches over here. I is splitted up into two different currents. That is why it is represented over here, I2 and I1. I is different. I is the current passing from here. When it reaches over here, it is split into two, I1 and I2. And there is a voltage difference V. You can see the voltage remains the same over here in R2 and R1. In series connection, I was constant. I remains the same, but in parallel what is happening is that V, potential difference over here in resistor 1 and resistor 2, remains the same. So the current from the battery from the positive terminal flows and comes to the head part of the resistor. Okay, this is the head part of the resistor. So the current I flows from here, comes to the head part. Okay, the current is split into two parts in a sense, I1 and I2. It is split into two parts. As the current is split into two parts, now voltage across the positive end of the battery, this is the voltage across the positive end of the battery. This voltage across the positive end of the battery is V. And the negative end of the battery, let us suppose this is zero. Okay, negative end of the battery is zero. So the potential difference would be capital V minus zero. So what would be the answer? V. Okay, V minus zero would be V. So from the positive end of the battery, the voltage is same at the head of the resistor. So the positive end of the battery, the voltage is same at the head of the resistor. Here it is zero. So here voltage would be zero. Here also voltage would be zero. Okay, so from the positive end of the battery, the voltage is the same at the head of the resistor. The head of the resistor voltage is same, V. And the negative end of the battery, the negative end of the battery voltage would be zero. Okay, so at the tail of the voltage flows from the negative end, and at the tail of the resistor has zero voltage. So therefore the tail of the resistors has zero voltage. So that is why here zero voltage is there. Since here there is zero voltage, so the tail of the resistors, there are zero voltage. So resistor R1, this is the resistor R1. Okay, the potential difference is equal to V, capital V, minus zero, because here it is zero. Since here the voltage is zero, so here it is also zero. So V minus zero, you will get V. Okay, that is what we get answer as V. So we have got the potential difference out here. We have taken this positive end of the resistor, it is V, and here it is zero. So voltage difference would be V minus zero. We'll get the answer as V. And the resistor R2, we get potential difference similarly. Capital V is the voltage difference over here. And here the voltage difference, since it is connected to the negative, here also zero, here also zero. So V minus zero would give you V. So parallel resistance, we need to understand these two concepts. This is very important in parallel connection. Okay, the resistance, first important rule in parallel connection is that you need to understand the resistors have the same head and the resistance have the same tail. Okay, so resistance have the same head means here you can see the heads are connected together. This is the head. Okay, this is the head and this is the tail end. Okay, and the second very important thing is that the voltage across the resistances, here the voltage across the resistances are the same. V, you have got over here V and here also V. So here in parallel connection, the voltage across the resistances is the same which is denoted by capital V.